The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. We are going to talk about hymen today. Imperforate hymen. Hymen is basically a thin membrane and it most often covers a part of the opening of a female vagina. But imperforate hymen is something which basically covers the whole part, the whole opening of the vagina. And imperforate hymen is most common type of blockage which happens in the vagina. All right. And this imperforate hymen is something a girl is born with and no one knows why this happens, but it can happen and there is nothing which anybody or even or the mother did to it to cause it, right? Obviously. And to diagnose it, a girl can be diagnosed with an imperforate hymen at any age, but the most commonly it is diagnosed at puberty or sometimes at birth also. At birth or early childhood, the doctor, healthcare provider might notice that there is no opening in the hymen during a physical exam. Or at puberty, the girls, when they start having problems, because the girls will have problems because they do not have any opening in the vagina. So when they will start bleeding in the periods, right, the first time, the imperforate hymen will block the blood from flowing out. All right. Therefore, the blood will back up in the vagina and it will get like a mass or a fullness in the lower abdomen because of that, from the buildup of the blood that cannot come out. And therefore, there will be fullness or mass in the abdomen. It can lead to stomach pain. It can lead to back pain or problems with the urinating and even bowel movements. Right. In that case, you obviously you'll approach a doctor and the doctor will do a complete pelvic exam and the doctor will also do a pelvic ultrasound and even other kind of imaging studies to study the kidneys and other stuff if everything is right. And this is done obviously to ensure that imperforate hymen, rather than any other problem, if it is actually an imperforate hymen instead of any other problem, right, then the doctor will recommend this. Then you have to go to a for a surgery, obviously, because for treatment of imperforate hymen you need a minor surgery, and where a small cut, an incision is made, and a small part of the extra hymen membrane is removed, right? And most oftenly, obviously, the surgery is done when the girl child becomes older and starts having their period during the puberty, or maybe it can be done when they start growing their breasts or pubic hairs, they start become, right, that time, right? And obviously the surgery will allow the menstrual blood to come out and can allow some part of hymen to stay there. That is also normal, right? And the surgery, you will recover in a few days. It's not a major surgery, it's a minor surgery. And after surgery, the girl may have to actually insert dilators into the vagina for 15 minutes every day, right? This dilator basically looks like a tampon and this basically keeps the incision from closing itself and keeps the vagina open, right? So this also can be there, and the girls will obviously recover. They will not have any problem. They will have normal periods. They can use tampons. They have normal sexual intercourse later and can have children in life. There is no problem in future. So this is all about imperforate hymen. It's not what you thought, I know, but this thing exists. All right. So I'll see you tomorrow with something interesting. Stay connected. Stay healthy.